Hi, my name is Erica Gomez, and I'm a software development manager at Amazon. I really like it because I get to develop more junior engineers and help them grow in their careers and find the right opportunities for them. And I have to think more strategically as opposed to tactically. When you're planning out your day, brainstorming ideas for a project, or choosing songs for a party, how do you keep track of all your activities, ideas, or songs? You probably write them down in a list. Lists help us stay organized by ordering all the relevant pieces of information, one after the other, in a single place. The same principle applies when we write programs that include many related pieces of information. Variables are useful for keeping track of a single piece of information. But as we collect more and more information, keeping the variables organized can be complicated. For example, what if you wanted to keep track of everybody's name in class or an entire school? It's impractical to create hundreds or thousands of individual variables, and impossible if you don't know how many items should be tracked ahead of time. In JavaScript, we can keep track of all these things by using an array. An array is an ordered collection of items. You can think of an array as a row of numbered boxes. Each box can have one item in it. Arrays can hold all types of data: numbers, strings, and even other arrays. Let's see how you could use an array to keep track of the names of people in a group. In JavaScript, an array of strings looks like this. Notice that all the items in the array are separated by commas, and the entire array is in brackets. Just like how you can assign a number or a string to a variable, like var x gets 5, you can also assign an array to a variable to use it later, like this. Every time you make a new array, you'll want to assign it to a variable so that you can find it again. Your array can be as long as you want. Just use the arrow keys on the side of the block to make it longer or shorter. To access an individual item from your array, write out the name of the array and the number of the box you want to access, like this. This means, give me the item in the list names sitting in slot number 2. The official term for slot number 2 is index. You might have noticed that the first index in the array is 0. In programming, we usually start counting at 0, which means that names at index 0 is the first item of the array, and names at index 2 is actually the third item in the array. When your program runs, the computer will look up the current value that lives at the given index of the array, just like the computer looks up the current value of a variable. Arrays are a very powerful way to write programs that use large amounts of data. They open the door for us to write programs that use and process lots and lots of information, especially when we don't know ahead of time just how much information needs to be stored. Let's try them out.